Good evening. I'm Ace Wolf, and this is your Nightly News Flash. Our top story for this evening showcases the sordid tale of a bright star's descent into the seedy underworld of children's television. The Bandura and Bobo show saw skyrocketing network ratings almost immediately after its first show on the BCP network 6 years ago. With weekly lessons about getting along with one's neighbor and dealing with the anger one feels inside, it became the most promising children's show in years.
When I discovered them in a dingy little comedy club about 10 years ago, I knew that I found the next big thing. Their act was a little violent, but their energy and chemistry was great.
Those were the days. Women were all over me before all this stuff for kids. I feel like becoming a children's television icon desexualized me overnight. But I mean, hey, I guess I'm helping the kids.
But behind that perfect smile and those pleasant antics, there was a darker side to Bandura K. Farnsworth.
Well, that's all the time we have for you today on the Bandura and Bobo. What the fuck is this? Oh, I can't work with this shit, man. I can't work with it. What did you say to me? What the fuck?
Yeah, Bandura's kind of high-strung. We try to keep the show itself peaceful, because, I mean, we don't want the kids seeing that kind of stuff. Plus, I mean, it'd be against format. We had a show a while back that featured me teaching kids how to bounce back from violent situations. I think that Bandura liked hitting me a bit too much. All I can say is that I feel bad for Nancy.
I'm Mr. Farnsworth's assistant. He's a really great guy, really. He's just under a lot of stress, you know? So many deals, I mean.
When I started watching these guys back in the comedy club, I knew that their violence was really more a matter of criticizing violence. It's far too ridiculous to be considered real or to be encouraging real violence in the slightest. Then I realized that Bandura really doesn't care about kids or his fans. He's just in it for the money.
Yeah, I've got a couple deals with toy companies here and there, but I'd never accept under-the-table deals from any company or rep stuff that shouldn't have any sort of connection to the kids.
But he did, does, and will. Furthermore, it would seem that that star has been investing all of that extra cash into more than a few destructive habits.
Yeah, I've been dealing with that fool for years. That sucker's my best client, know what I'm saying? Just between you and me, I think that dummy's crazy, G. That dummy's gonna fuck us all up one of these days. Straight truth. Unforgivable!
Bandura's shameful behavior soon landed him squarely in the hands of authorities, and Bandura soon found himself in rehab. Unfortunately, though despite this somewhat hopeful turn, Bandura was soon back to his old self.
Rehab? You're fucking asking me if I plan on going back into rehab? Fuck you, man. I'm fucking Bandura Farnsworth. I do whatever the fuck I want.
Tragic. We'll be right back after these messages.
So many songs about rainbows, and what's on the other side? Rainbows are visions, but only illusions, and rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.